The World Bank's pronouncement comes at a time when government loans worth 5.223 trillion shillings are in the pipeline from the World Bank under various stages of preparation and approval. These include $150 million, about 542.828 billion shillings for the investment in industrial transformation and employment projects. $518 million, approximately 1.874 trillion shillings, to finance the Greater Kampala Metropolitan Area Project Integrated Transport Infrastructure and Services. $325 million, about 1.176 trillion shillings, to finance the Climate Smart Agriculture Project and the loan request to refurbish Kampala Kasese Meter Gauge Integrated Transport Infrastructure and Services to a tune of $450 million, about 1.628 trillion shillings.
Bank, IMF, and all these institutions and countries is to respect the legislative sovereignty of Uganda and Ugandans. Unless they want to tell us that each time we want to make a law, we should first consult America or World Bank and IMF. Please, we are consulting you. Will this law be acceptable to you? Then if they say it is acceptable, we bring it back to Parliament and debate it. But then where will that leave our legislative sovereignty?
As you're aware, Uganda is gradually moving towards funding its budget almost to 60%. That also is a signal to us that we must have a sense of frugality, and make sure that we cut our jackets according to our size and prioritize our expenditure.
Legislators are concerned that the future is uncertain for Uganda, though they don't regret passing the anti-gay law, saying no price can be attached to values and norms of Uganda.
This goes back to the government, especially the government officials, the president inclusive. They have for so long been extravagant. They've been getting loans, they've been getting grants, and they have been misusing that money. Now that the money lender, who has been actually helping us, is stepping aside, now that even those ones who were actually willing to help us, just giving us grants, they are quitting, that means we are going to be like, we are in a dilemma.
It is a learning curve. Once somebody has denied you a loan, he gives you ability to think better. So, and there are very many international friends from whom we can borrow. So,
in May 2023, President Museveni signed into law the Anti-Homosexuality Act 2023, making homosexuality illegal in Uganda. World Bank concluded that no new public financing to Uganda will be presented to Board of Executive Directors for approval until the efficacy of the additional measures has been tested. Legislators have urged government to step up frugality.
It's hurting, it will hurt our economy, but we are prepared. We are going to tighten our belts, because what we did, definitely, we are Africans, we are Ugandans, who could not deviate from the normal. We cannot behave like those, some of those people. But I know eventually the message they have is different. I trust the president. I trust most of these Ugandans. These people shall tell them the truth. They don't know what we did. We are saying a man should not marry a man.
There's no price you can put to the value, to the values of this country. So if that's the decision is theirs, we'll see how to adjust ourselves going forward.
Asman Basalirwa, the Bujili municipality legislator who led parliament in enactment of the Anti-Homosexuality Act, says Uganda can shift to Middle East countries where government can access cheaper loans with less conditions.
I have advised the people, let's look for new friends. Let's look for new partners. World Bank is not funding anything in Afghanistan. Aren't they surviving? So let's look for new partners. Let's look for new friends. let's go to the Middle East, let's go to the Arab world.
The World Bank's decision comes at the backdrop of March 2023 report on public debt, grants, guarantees and liabilities for 2022-2023, which revealed that Uganda's outstanding debt stock, including arrears from multilateral creditors, is largely from the International Development Association of the World Bank, representing 55% of the total public debt. In the financial year 2022-2023 alone, Parliament approved several loans from the World Bank to a tune of 2.239 trillion shillings. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.